If you don't have enough compelling content, eventually, like, just tools and platforms don't do much at all. They push this impossible boundaries. They push you to like new opportunity spaces. But someone has to actually go and grasp and build these opportunities. Like, if someone creates fire, everyone was like, nah, just put some water on this fire and like turn it off. Like, you just miss the whole point of fire. So technology and hardware innovations are increasingly like getting innovated super, super fast. Actually, right now, ironically, the hardware has gone faster than the actual content. So we're at this very laughable point in time where what we can do with hardware is much more than what we're actually doing from it. And it's like a software person dream, you know, you're like, there's all this stuff we can do, but like, we don't have enough time to do all of them, let's just do stuff and like, let's experiment. So it's amazing. So if you don't have enough content, if you don't have enough people just actually consuming it and having ease of use, accessibility, all these tools are just like useless. So this is what we focus on in Weaver at least, and any other company that does content stuff and creation, giving people the powers to do stuff, as creators, artists, and designers, and making this content come to life, distributing it, getting as much people as possible, people who have no access to vibes and so on, and which is why we think it's pretty amazing. The other thing I want to say also is that a lot of people are skeptical about, as you know, I'm doing a lot of themes about like how to just fight off skeptics, because so there was this like, I'm not gonna appropriate this quote, not, I didn't do it. So like a few days ago, I don't know if you're aware, it was Oculus conference, which is like the annual conference VR, and there was a quote that was taken from someone else, but she said it's Oculus said it, I forgot who said it initially, which is about like just how revolutions happen in technology. So for evolution to happen, like we tend to think about it as like, oh, like now the age of, I don't know, smartphones happen, and it's among us, and it's happening, you just have to wait next year to have it. But for it to actually happen, all you need is just enough smart people taking enough time off of like what they're doing, stopping everything, and putting enough efforts, the right time in the right place. So like, we are this revolution. Like if let's say five of you right now just stop what they're doing and focus on VR, like you are such a small proportion of like, and so that's a big portion of the community, because the community is so, so small that you will have direct near impact on it. So we either just all do it together, or it's not going to happen. You can't just wait and say like, oh, Moore's law, in 2 years, computers will be faster. You have people actually building this hardware, like spending every day in, day out, optimizing stuff. You can't just wait for things to happen. And the other quote was being very cheesy, of course. Other quote from Steve Jobs, I think was better. Oh, super cheesy now, from Steve Jobs. Anyway. It was something about like, I'm probably not misquoting, but okay, it's something like we tend to think about, and this is like one of the best quotes ever of technology. We tend to think about technology, or like, sorry, about the world and life around us. Like this thing is kind of like, it's here. So this is us, and there's the world, and it's a given, right? So we're just a drop in the ocean, and that's all there is. And we just take it for granted, and people tell us like, yeah, just listen to what your parents are saying, or like, just science is telling you, and just like, find your spot in yourself in this kind of hole and just be a part of it. But the moment you just realize that you can just poke into the world and make some changes, if you can just like literally just right now open your laptop, write some code, and create something like, I don't know, like Instagram, right? Or you can just get Unity, get Unreal, start building some stuff, get Google Cardboard if you want money or anything you want, just start building some stuff. Like you are actually changing the world like on that instant. And if you realize how much agency you have, go back to VR and this whole analogy, if you have agency to change the world itself, you stop looking at the world, you know, in the same way, like forever. You start thinking about, this is clay, and I'm modeling. Even if it's a small scale, like, you're actually a building shit. Whoever is a cow here now, like, you don't realize how fortunate you are. You are part of the 0.00000001% of the population of humankind right now, who even knows what VR is, who has some ability to be involved in it and like shape. Most people, my parents, might be from other countries or anyone else, would hear about what VR is in 15 years when it's actually like, quite polished and like, you can just put on some glasses or some lenses or whatever, and then, oh, you can actually do blah, 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 VR. That's kind of cool. It was like my parents knew there was something called internet a few years ago. They're like, bro, this is not new. It's just like, it's just finally reached you as this ripple effect. So just like, go out and just make shit. That's all I have to say. Yeah, I guess that's like mainly it from happen and then content, great stuff. But yeah, so I don't want to bore you with just like one way things. Just if you have any questions, just shoot them, anything. Doesn't have to be anything related to what I'm saying. If you like, I'm not just talking about bro, or just, I want to know about burritos or whatever. So, and obviously, shoot me any more or anything, but whatever. So, cool. Yeah, so go ahead. What's your name?
Amber.
Amber, of course. Yeah, totally, okay. Just preface without avoiding the question. As I was mentioning before, even if I had a good answer for this, A, it would be totally wrong, because who knows what's gonna happen. You can't predict what's happened in 20 years. Also, like, humans are always much, they always like mess up predictions when it comes to like short-term and long-term. They'll think, oh, in 2 years it's gonna happen, never happened. In 10 years it's never gonna happen, actually happens. So depending on what time scale you're talking about. And B, like, I think the main, I personally think that the main advantage of VR is just pushing the just impossible, just allowing us to be there. The people who are born now, by the way, there's some people who are like 3-4 years old who are experiencing vibes in VR. I mean, they are obviously privileged. But even if you have a cardboard, which is $5, and then you have a phone, most people have smartphones now. You have a smartphone or a cardboard, you experience VR when you're 3. The way you grow up viewing the world is so different than someone who was a medieval person who grew up with like swords and horses. So I think this is like, I just think this is the main. But in terms of much more practical stuff, VR is changing so many different industries. I'll give you examples. Medical field, right? You can do like remote surgery stuff with VR. You can do like even like live streaming of 60 videos inside the colonoscopy, like thing inside the human body, look like what's happening, do stuff like that. You can do like training for doctors. A lot of companies are doing now like some kind of first person VOD, like with a surgeon, monitoring surgery, someone else can watch and train it. Some companies in AR, very similar software. Adding like annotation on it and training them and having this remote kind of collaboration, etc. Education, what's better than actually being in the context of what you're talking about? So if you want to learn about molecules and you can teleport to like an actual molecule and see how it's working in an enzyme, say, and then see like stuff happening. You know those like very clunky videos you show us in school, kind of guess somebody probably under. Like where you have like these red and blue molecules happening, whatever, and this is how DNA gets made. Just like super like abstract and non, like you can't really relate to it. But if you experience it, like if you go there and do it, whether it's this or like history, geography, you go back in time and see like how Napoleon was and actual previous video scene and so on. And so many other things. Same for communication, productivity for work, the history of the talk and stuff over here. So many other things about how we go about life. Social VR is crazy. Like the way you just feel you're somewhere else, the empathy you're feeling, any empathy tool. Creation, like increasing the pie of like creators by giving more people just to do stuff. And any other field, like, it's just, it's all over the place. Journalism, there's so many of them. I can talk about more specifics if you want after this, but yeah. Obviously, like the ones more relevant to us, because I'm talking about like other things just to show more breadth, is entertainment and like anything kind of more compelling, kind of real experiences that are immersive, whether it's like more like movies or games and so on. We do more like experiences of art. Meant to be immersive and consumed. And also there's like a lot of remakes of like music. So they have like this piece with that very old friend where you can hear inside the song in the music video and like you like become one with it, which is a very different way of thinking about music and so on. And yeah, the other thing I just remember what I wanted to say earlier when I was babbling down. So the other thing I want to say is that people tend to think about gaming as like the only or like most obvious thing for VR. It's a huge misconception. It's like saying it's only for academics in the 90s, people who are only doing research on what are PhDs. It's a huge misconception. The two or three reasons why gaming is thought of as like the thing for VR, or that VR is only going to be a fad, end up with gaming. A is because today, people who have PCs that are powerful enough to run the 2016 technology of VR are gamers, because gamers usually update their computers and have graphics cards and so on for their 3D games usually. And they have like this fancy hardware. So for them, buying a Vive, let's say, is just the same as buying an iPhone. For rest of us who don't have PCs or that fancy, it's buying a new PC and buying a new one and so on. So A, from a consumer standpoint, if you just fast forward 2-3 years, where it's just the average time between which people just update their PCs and just get new PCs, even if the price doesn't go lower, people would naturally have PCs that are that powerful. So it would be like huge, much huge, much bigger product. Also, if the prices of everything is decreasing and Moore's law and so on. So this is completely like my opinion view of thinking about what can be done from a consumer standpoint. B, from the developer standpoint, just happens that most game engines used for developing VR on the CG side are Unity and Unreal. Most people currently have experience with those and they really, really like natural familiarity with it are people from gaming industry or from like, Pixar or whatever, right? So these people just already know how to build this kind of stuff, so it's natural for them. But a lot of tools are happening to introduce developing VR and VR from Unity, like check out Carflong or Running Dolls, or even Flowbrush Media. These tools are allowing you to create stuff for VR from within VR. So these will automatically grow the pie of creation once we figure it out. And see, just because gaming itself is extremely better than VR. It's just so compelling. Like, if you play something like Spaceflight Trainer or anything like that, you're inside the game, so it feels so good. But these things about VR is like the thing that's as big, if not 10 times bigger than the internet for smartphones. It will eat away so many things. And people 20 years from now will look back and say, like, can't believe people used to be skeptical about this. So, yeah, sorry. What's your name?
John.
Someone who's living, let's say, in Africa and a small tribe that has internet connection that is connected to Facebook can have a very, very different bubble. So yes, there is a fear of like, having more and more bubbles, and then you end up having this clash in the real world. Like for example, what's happening with selection, people have like, how can people are so different from what I think, and then vice versa, and so on. If people are so used to living in their own bubble, like cocoon, that they don't interact with other people, this could definitely happen in VR, because you're literally in a different world. You have a metaverse where even locked like password zones, you don't even get there. The other thing that could be very, very kind of disturbing is, I would say it's the amount of time in VR, I would say that it's like what happens in VR. So if you have social VR, if you try the town space, for example, you have the avatar, so I'm walking around. How do you like preserve, how do you define first and preserve the rights and ethics of your avatar? So if you, what happens, I'm just like, this is saying of this like, kind of triggering term, it's very real. What happens if your avatar gets raped? Like you're in VR, right? Like you're in VR. This is very serious. There's a lot of companies actually working on like defining these code of conduct and so on, and like how do you deal with it? I mean, obviously you can take off the headset, but it's so much more like real than you think. It's so visceral. Like if you get abused or like stolen or like beat up in VR, yeah, it's really, really bad, you know what I mean? Right. And what happens if, let's say I want to be in VR and I want to, so to avoid this kind of problem, I want to define my privacy zone. So I only allow people to interact with me whatever I want, have this kind of like soundproof zone that I won't get anything else from other people unless I admit them. Then you end up with more and more bubbles of like this, I only interact with two people in VR, my whole life is there and so on. So there are so many things to figure out about ethics and like societal implications about VR. But same with anything else. And I would say it's a good problem to have. It's like anything before. It's like, you want to have smartphones and have to worry about how to include in society, or you don't want to have smartphones? Of course I want to have smartphones. And it's also like, it's kind of like a curse of humanity, that we're so like greedy to have more and better. Also, by the way, it's a big parenthesis, like a big tangent. But on a very different topic, like, don't you guys think it's ironic that it's 2016 and it's assumed that people have to work more than three quarters of their life? It's like, if humanity has progressed so much from prehistory to now, why do we still need a society, every single member of the community, like every population member, to work 40, 80 hours a week before we can just like have peace and pleasure? It's because the other side is the point of all this. Whether it's capitalism or anything else, because society as a whole pushes for more, it's not like consumerism, it's just more and more polished things. So you could stop in years 1000 or 1950 or whatever, whenever the first internet thing happened. You could say, okay, guys, as an industry, let's just stop with the internet, let's not produce anything else, and let's all enjoy the 20 hours a week of freedom we have while the machines are taking over our lives. We don't need to produce like things like Tinder, who cares about that? We don't need to have Amazon Now where you can get a roll of toilet paper the next hour. You can wait for a day, I don't mind. We just stop everything right now, and we start enjoying the extra issue coming out of society. But that's not how it works, because as humans, we're always curious for more, always like eager to see the future. We even like, this is how religions like are born. We want to know how things are made and how much we can push further. And this whole like metaphysical thing about our reincarnation right now, like if this is how much progress we make in VR, what if we fast forward 100 years, 1000 years, 10,000 years, 100,000 years, a million years from now, what would VR look like? And if we can achieve that much immersion, then maybe we're already there right now. Right? You know, there's always this kind of like curiosity of the future. So it never works in a way that like, let's stop innovating and just like, let's worry about all the risks that can happen. If anything, I think our core mission as human beings is just to keep pushing forward in terms of like how much epicness we can make in terms of getting more like, you know, pleasure and like happiness and actual real moral and ethical part of life and push our humanity forward. And with anything, there's gonna be like pros and cons. It's a great problem to have. It's awesome. It's much better than me like being like, oh, I wonder if like having cars without horses is a good thing. People are gonna get hit by cars. Of course, man. So anything else? I don't know if that answers the question.
Yeah. So,
totally, yeah. And this is also the thing. You know, like when drugs came out, and this is still a debate: should weed be legal or not? You know, it's always like that. With anything. And I'm not saying that like this means everything should be legal. I'm just saying that like anything important enough worth having a debate is important for a reason, right? And usually, like if something is that revolutionary and risks shaping the whole matter of society, it means it's a fucking epic thing. Let's just figure it out together. Let's just make it better. And same thing for artificial intelligence. Like, what if AIs, what if robots take over the world and kill us? And there are nonprofits that are working specifically on making AI ethical, and it's such a hard problem to solve, by the way. There's so